Hello dear students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Gagandeep Kaur, Assistant Professor, Khalsa College of Education, Ranjit Avenue, Amritsar. Today we will discuss about the topic Formative and Summative Evaluation, its concept, nature and purposes. After studying this topic, the learners will be able to define formative and summative evaluation. Differentiate between the nature of formative and summative evaluation. Discuss the purpose of formative and summative evaluation. Know the role of formative and summative in the teaching learning process. As we know, at present, different evaluation pattern is followed in different institutions. The most common practices of evaluation are half yearly and annual examination system. The duty of the teacher is to evaluate the students' performances by providing them different types of tests. Tests which are given to students are like cognitive and non-cognitive tests, criterion and norm reference tests, and formative and summative depending upon the nature of the class size, content and interests of both students and teachers. In case of pupil evaluation, schools might be interested in knowing the learning behaviors of students or reason for uneven progress in the achievement of students. For that, some alternative evaluation approaches may be needed. All evaluations are conducted with a specific objective in mind, and the type of evaluation to be conducted must be planned according to the objective. Many a time, evaluation may be required for a specific group of students, and at the other times, evaluation may be needed for the whole school or class. For better teaching, learning process and outcomes, the role of evaluation is very prominent. So here, in this module, we will discuss in detail about formative and summative evaluation and more specifically, their nature and purposes. Now we will discuss about the concept and nature of formative evaluation. In 1967, Michael Sacrivan has used these two terms, formative and summative evaluation, for the first time in the context of curriculum evaluation. He observed that evaluation has two main functions. Firstly, to evaluate students on regular basis, and secondly, once in a yearly basis. So, for the regular assessment of students' learning and to know their level of achievement in their prescribed subject, teachers in the schools or other institutions use the formative assessment. According to Sacrivan, 1980, formative evaluation is conducted during development or improvement of a program or product. It is an evaluation conducted for in-house staff and normally remains in-house, but it may be done by an internal or external evaluation or by a combination of both. Formative evaluation is that evaluation which is conducted with the objective of modifying the performance. It is conducted during the implementation phase to check whether implementation is being done according to the plan or not. It enables the learner to understand their progress in learning, their weaknesses, and to take the necessary remedial measures to correct their learning. It provides support and feedback to learner to improve their ongoing learning. This assessment comprises of all those activities designed to motivate, to enhance understanding and to provide learners with an indication of their progress. The nature of formative assessment can be observed in classroom situation where individual differences exist in learning and the quality of learning because students' pace of learning is different. The confirmed time within which certain amount of learning has to take place varies from learner to learner. In order to provide information regarding quantity, quality, pace and amount, formative assessment is must. This feedback is seen related to the cognitive, affective, and psychomotor domain of learning. The formative assessment provides feedback not only to the students but also to the teachers. It helps them to know about the effective completion of the course and to check whether specific objectives are achieved properly or not. If we will talk about its nature, the nature of formative assessment is feedback oriented. It provides feedback to the learner to monitor the progress of learning either at an assumed rate of learning or at their own rate of learning depending upon the individual differences. Formative tests measure the students' learning levels against the standards set up in the test. The effectiveness of testing lies in revealing what has been learnt by the learner correctly or whether standard level of achievement has been achieved. So, formative assessment is therefore not very meaningful in terms of assigning marks to the learners, and some experts tend to disregard the marks as they believe that this type of assessment becomes more meaningful when grades are given instead of marks. More success is achieved when the results of the tests are discussed with their students and their weaknesses are identified, and remedial measures are suggested later on. Generally, such formative assessments are conducted in the form of oral tests at the end of the unit for their mastery and acquisition ability. Next, we will discuss about the purpose of formative assessment. Students, the purposes and objectives of formative assessment are like to get information on the strength and weaknesses of the learners on the part of an individual. It determines the degree of mastery of a given learning task and also helps to identify that part of task which has not been mastered. Providing feedback both to the teacher and the learner about success or failure in mastering specific skills or components of the program constitutes an essential part of the teaching-learning process. The other purpose is to make it possible to point out weaknesses of the program and to identify those learners who need remedial teaching. Here, the main emphasis of formative evaluation is not to certify but to help both teacher and learner to improve their teaching-learning process. Again, the purpose of formative evaluation is to deal with information which will determine whether a student has learned to define, interpret, translate, and apply the principle of the content or not. If the students are not successful in doing this, she will be further given support, material, and resources to learn and to achieve the target. Well, students, I hope it is now clear the aim of formative evaluation is not to assign some grades, rather to provide feedback to both the learner and the teacher and to improve the teaching, learning method, media, material, techniques, and strategies on the whole. So, students, information of this type contributes more to the improvement of learning than the results of end-of-course testing. Now, we will discuss about the concept and nature of summative evaluation. According to Scriven, summative function of evaluation occurs after the program has been fully executed. Summative evaluation is conducted to determine how worth the final program was, especially in comparison with other competing programs. It is conducted after completion of a course of study and for the benefit of some external members or decision makers, though it may be done either by an internal or an external evaluator or by a combination of both. Summative assessments are given periodically to determine a particular point in time what students know and what they do not know. The point is to think of summative assessment as a means to gauge at a particular point of time the students' learning relative to the content standards. The information gathered from this type of assessment is important because it can help in evaluating certain aspects of the learning process. This type of assessment is spread out and occurs after every few weeks, months, or once in a year. It is like a tool to help evaluate the effectiveness of programs, school, or institutional improvement, alignment of curriculum, or students' placement in a specific program. Assessment that is predominantly of summative nature will not by itself be able to illustrate a valid measure of the growth and development of a child. It certifies the level of achievement only at a given point of time. Summative assessment takes place after the learning has been completed and provides information and feedback that sum up the teaching and learning process. No more formal learning takes place at this stage other than incidental learning, which might take place through the completion of the course and assignments. Summative tests are usually given at the end of a course or semester to assess what has been learned and how well it was learned. It could be used at the end of a unit of instruction when purpose is to grade the students. Grades are usually an outcome of summative assessment. So students, summative assessment answers the questions like whether the student has acceptable level of knowledge, are the students able to effectively progress to the next part of the class. On the other hand, we can say that the objective of summative assessment is to facilitate in classifying students according to their abilities and their selection for admission to a new course. Summative assessment is more product oriented and assesses the final product, unlike formative assessment. The aim of summative assessment is not to monitor the progress of the students during instruction, but to assess or grade the overall performance of the students to determine the extent to which the instructional objectives have been achieved and help the teachers to do course evaluation. Well, students, if we will talk about the purpose of summative evaluation, we can say the purpose of summative evaluation is to assess the success in reaching its stated goals. Summative evaluation as a progressive evaluation frequently addresses many questions, like it raises questions about to what extent the goal has been achieved or whether the course was fruitful, what were the drawbacks of the course. Let us understand the differences between formative and summative evaluation. According to Sacriven, there is no basic logical and methodological difference between formative and summative evaluation. Both are prepared to examine the worth of particular content, program, or curriculum. Only the time of evaluation and the way results are used in different contexts can indicate that whether the evaluation is formative or summative. Sometimes the same evaluation may be considered as formative by one group of evaluator and summative by another group of evaluator, depending up on their need and demand. The difference between formative and summative evaluation applies not only to the education but to many other fields as well. Formative evaluation delivers information during the institutional process and before the summative evaluation. Here, both the teacher and the student use this assessment result to make certain decisions about further action for future learning. So, it is ongoing, dynamic process which involves more frequently testing and measurement of students' learning as one of the course components, whereas results of summative assessment are generally used to make some sort of judgment and to determine a grade for students' classroom assignment, which measures course effectiveness and to determine the progress of an institution or school. Summative assessment is related to time and level for assessing learning, that is how much learning has taken place in a particular time and the level of students in a particular course, curriculum and school. Formative assessment is a tool in the hand of a teacher to monitor students' progress in a non-threatening, supportive environment. It provides regular feedback, give chance for students' improvement. On the other hand, summative evaluation produces enormous stress and anxiety among students because it is carried out at the end of the learning. The difference between formative and summative function of evaluation is important because it affects the process by which evaluation is carried out. Formative evaluation is an in-house work whose job is to help the learners to know their progress from time to time. Here, members of the team work both as developers and evaluators. Summative evaluation is an end work, of course, and is usually done by an external evaluator who should not be associated with the development team in order to avoid being biased. The summative evaluation is more likely to be responsive to the needs and requirements of the learners. Their two evaluations differ in instrumentation, research control, and generalizability. In case of formative evaluation, data tend to be collected through observation, questionnaires, interview, research control, and generalizability is not a major concern over here. In contrast, summative evaluation, data tend to be collected with standardized techniques having high validity and reliability. Research control and generalizability of results are built into the design of summative evaluation. So, students, the level of generalization is a matter of fact that differentiates formative to summative evaluation clearly. Formative evaluator may be interested in assessing students' knowledge, skills, and the ability to apply the principle in a limited and unfamiliar situation and context. Things are reversed in a case of summative evaluation because evaluator may try to assess the acquired knowledge, skills, and to apply it in a wider situation by covering the large portion of the syllabus. Formative evaluation focuses on assessment of students' achievement or competences related to a limited sample of content, whereas in summative evaluation, the sample of content is larger due to more content coverage. Therefore, the marks and grades provided to the students in summative evaluation suffer from sampling limitation and there is a probability of sampling error. Well, students, the framework of summative evaluation therefore requires careful planning and process not only in content but also the ability specified under various assessment objectives. The focus of formative evaluation is to check learning, locating the weaknesses of students and suggesting remedial steps for improvement in learning. Whereas summative evaluation focuses on measurement of achievement, grading and certification of students' achievement. It is more product oriented and assesses the final product, whereas formative assessment focuses on the process towards completing the product. If we differentiate between the purposes of both the evaluation, as we discussed before, the purpose of formative evaluation tells us that it deals with the information related to the strength and weaknesses of the learning part of an individual, success or failure in mastering specific skills. It provides feedback to the learner and to improve the teaching learning process, it is must. Similarly, in this unit, we come to know about another evaluation system, that is summative assessment. The concept of summative assessment is to indicate that whether learners have reached to the level of knowledge or not, and to determine the extent to which the instructional objectives have been achieved. Being a progressive evaluation, its purpose is to assess the success in reaching its stated goals. So students, thus we have discussed the differentiation of formative and summative evaluation on the basis of course component, acquisition of knowledge and skill level of achievement. They differ in process and product as well, in instrumentation, research and control. So it is concluded that the formative evaluation is that evaluation which is conducted with the objective to modify the performance. It is conducted during the implementation phase to check whether the implementation is being done according to plan or not. Summative assessment is carried out basically at the end of some process or at the end of a particular unit and determines that how much learning has taken place in a particular time and the level of the students, course curriculum and school. Formative evaluation is to check learning, locating the weaknesses of the students and suggesting remedial steps for improvement in learning. Whereas summative evaluation focuses on measurement of achievement, grading and certification of students' achievement. In this unit, the main focus of discussion was about formative evaluation and summative evaluation. We started a discussion with the concept and nature of formative evaluation. Then we come to know about what is formative evaluation, its nature and how the students meet the stated goals. Secondary students in a classroom are diversified in a nature looking at their diverse backgrounds. And several questions arises like, do a greater number of students showing their interest for receiving knowledge in their interest areas? Which areas are most effective and which areas need improvement? Were the results worth for the course? Are there any changes in courses or can the course be sustained? In brief, we can say that summative evaluation is to assess the nature as course success in reaching its stated goals by collecting information about outcomes and related processes, strategies and activities that have led to them. To record or report an estimate of students' achievement depending upon the setting and goals. I hope now the concept is clear to you. Thank you so much for watching.